Welcome to our state-of-the-art simulation lab at Penn State Scranton, where future nursing professionals learn by doing.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning, Annie.
My name's Amaya. I'm one of your nurses.
And my name is Lauren.
Today, our students work with Sim Annie, a lifelike geriatric mannequin designed to simulate real medical emergencies.
Hi, Anne. We're here, your nurses, this morning. How are you?
Annie isn't feeling well. Nursing students begin checking her vital signs, reviewing her medical history, and assessing her medications.
Alrighty, so we see here you have a little bit of bruising and your injury on your foot.
Yes.
Okay, and that started about 3 weeks ago, you said?
Yes.
And we do know that you have a history of type 2 diabetes. Do you know how your sugars usually run? Are you in the higher range?
200 to 300.
200 to 300, and you take insulin for that, right?
Yes.
Alrighty.
I'm going to check your sugar now.
Oh.
So what is the current sugar?
310.
Okay.
Behind the scenes, a skilled instructor controls Annie's responses and reactions.
Is she gonna be okay?
As they observe neurological changes, the team starts to suspect something serious.
Okay, are you able to see, look at my nose, are you able to see my hand on this side?
Yes.
Are you able to see my hand on this side?
No.
Guiding the simulation in real time, faculty can observe from a dedicated viewing area, evaluating how students communicate, make decisions, and respond under pressure.
What's going on with your hand and your leg?
I don't know.
Is it, like I asked you earlier, is it feeling tingly, stabbing?
They're weak.
They're feeling weak. Okay, so we are starting to see a little bit of a facial. Okay.
So.
And we're just gonna ask you a quick question. Can you tell us your name and your date of birth?
Yes. Annie, I'm 65.
Okay, are you feeling any lightheadedness, headache, dizzy, confused? Yes.
The team identifies the signs of stroke. They call a stroke alert.
So what we're going to do is we're just going to call an RRT now, and we're going to get in contact with your doctor just to rule out any stroke symptoms.
And prepare Annie for transport to the ICU, just like they would do in a real hospital.
Okay, and was there any major surgery or traumas within the last 14 days we should be aware of?
No.
And then was there a stroke, major head trauma, or intracranial surgery within the past 3 months?
No.
This immersive experience helps students build clinical confidence, sharpen critical thinking, and learn to work as a team.
AVM or aneurysms?
No.
Okay. And there was no recent myocardial infarction?
No.
And there was no symptoms of a seizure in the onset?
No.
And then do we have that score?
Yes, 16.
16?
In our simulation lab, learning is hands-on, high impact, and life-saving. Because when it comes to patient care, practice makes professionals.
Okay. So TPA is indicated after the checklist, so let's get her up to the ICU as fast as possible.
Ready. Thank you.